I have a computer connected to my network, and I want to be able to print from my Linux Mint Mate computer to that printer. To add that printer in, I'm going down to Menu, Administration, Printers. Here I see a dialog box with the title, Printers, Localhost. I will click on this plus sign Add button. This opens up the new printer dialog box. Over on the left, we see devices LPT1, Serial Port 1, Serial Port 5. If we had a printer directly connected to this computer, this is what we would use. My printer is on the network. So I'm going to click Network Printer. HP LaserJet Professional. This is the printer I want to connect. Over on the right, we've got some options here for connections, and at the top, we've got a description. This first one is HP Linux Imaging and Printing. This is a printer scan fax machine all in one. My description says HPLIP software driving a printer, or the printer functioning as a multi-function device. This sounds like what I want. Clicking down the next one just to see what that does. Changes the description. Here this is telling us that it's the software driving a fax machine. This does have a fax machine, but I don't use it that often. Most often I print and scan, so I will select this first one and click forward. Now it's asking me for a printer name. And putting in the device name that it gives it, very technical, I am going to change this name to Charlie Brown. It does not allow spaces, so I'm using the underscore. I'm calling this printer Charlie Brown just to give it something unique. It's common for people to use Star Wars characters, Greek gods. I've even seen them named after famous dogs. So this printer I'll call Charlie Brown. If I have another one, I might call it Lucy or Linus or Snoopy. But this one's Charlie Brown. Now the description, I will change this to be HP Scanner Printer All-in-One. And then I will give this the location of the office. Applying this. Tells me it's installed. Do I want to print a test page? I will. It printed the test page okay. So I can click OK here. If I want to change this name, I will right click on this and click on Rename. I will change this to Lucy, and now my printer is Lucy. Let's go back to Charlie Brown. And now I want to try scanning something in to make sure the scanner part works. I'll go into Menu, Graphics, and then simple scan. I'll scan in what is on the scanner. I have a failed to scan. I went into the documents preferences and it looks like it should find it. It has our HP LaserJet Professional. All this information looks correct, but for some reason it's unable to connect. I'm going down to Menu, Software Manager, and I don't know if you remember or not, but when we were installing the printer, we had something called the HPLIP software. So I'm going to check for that to make sure that's installed, and here we see yes, it's installed, but we also have something called HPLIP-GUI. Clicking that tells us this package contains utilities with graphical user interface for the HPLIP, HP tools, and HP fax. I'm going to install this. Now, if you have an Epson or a Canon printer, this won't work for that. You'll probably have to check the internet, but those might just install right away and not have this problem either. It is installed. I'm going to close this. I'm going to try and scan in my document again. I still have the problem. I'm going into administration and see if I can find that HP scan. There it is under preferences. HPLIP, I mean. It found my printer and I wanted to check the scanner. So I'll try scanning. The HP device proprietary plugin is missing. Okay, so I need to install the proprietary plugin. I'll click next. We need the password. Now I want to download and install the plugin from HP authorized server. Yes. The license agreement I will agree to. Plugin successful. Good. Let's try opening the scanner again. Scan. And I hear it starting up. And it is working. Scanning in my page that's on the scanner. I may want to crop this a little bit. Make it more like this. Then I'll save it. It saves as a JPEG. I'll put this into my pictures folder. Oh, we have things working, but we still have this HP down in the corner here. I don't want to see that anymore. So what I'm going to do is remove that. Going back to the software manager. Typing in HPLIP. And I'm going to remove this GUI that we added in. It is still here now. I will log out and log back in. And logging back in shows us the HP blue sign over here is gone. Let's make sure our scanner still works. Scanning again. But since it already loaded in the driver, it should work fine. And now I see it scanning. So we have successfully installed the printer scanner onto our Linux Mint Mate system. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.